So for today, we're going to be looking at my Viking set for all of the classes. If you guys don't know, two of these have been showcased in two videos. Specifically, the Hunter has been showcased in the Iron Companion set, and the Titan was showcased in the Iron Companion set for the Titans as well. Both of them right here if you guys want to check it out. Really, really love a lot of these sets. Some of these sets are some of my favorite sets that I've made in a long time, and I definitely would recommend to check it out because, again, they're really, really good. But for this one, we're just going to be showcasing the Viking themes, and for the Warlock, actually is a new set, kind of. I think I've showcased this one, maybe? If I can find the video, I'll have it up right now, but I don't think I've showcased this one, and I actually really, really, really like it. So again, if you guys like the video, like, comment, subscribe, I really do appreciate y'all, but other than that, let's get into it. So for the Hunter, this one is legitimately, I want to say my favorite. Now, that being said, I do think the Iron Companion helmet is not the best set for this. But at the same time, it's also really, it's the best set now. If we got some more armor sets from Destiny 1, I do think some of the Rise of Iron sets would be way better for this. But yeah, for the helmet, Iron Companion, easy choice because that is the most like Viking themed helmet I could find. Canis Luna grips because I think the armor goes really well with the Valhund ornament for the Six Coyote. The Iron Four Understrides was an easy choice as well, just because I like the uniformity between the rope at the legs. I think that was really good. Also, the Dick Cloth is also really good for this set. And then Mantle of Ephrodite was an easy choice because I don't know if you guys saw, but I'm trying to put as much fur in this set as much as I can. And this is probably one of my favorite sets that I've made in the game for a long time, just because a lot of these pieces just look like they were made for each other. Again, Canis Luna, I love the armor. I never use these arms, but for this set, I just thought it looked amazing because the Canis Luna armor pieces look really good, like almost Nordic, and also has a lot of fur, which again, I'm trying to put as much fur in there. Shadering Iron to Steel for pretty much any piece that had armor was a no choice because, or easy choice, I should say, because again, I want to have that plate look and I don't want to detract from that from having other pieces. For the chest piece, Gambit Celadon was an easy, well, I say easy choice, but if I find a better green out there, I'll probably choose that because the waist has a belt, obviously, but underneath the belt, you can see this white. That white actually does change color, and unfortunately, Gambit Celadon changes it to white. Now, if I find a shader that does literally everything but changes that into a green, I would love it even more, but it's not that big a deal if I'm being quite honest. And then for the shader for Mantle of Ephrodite, Iron Fistsight was an easy choice just because the texture of, like, I don't know what it is. I think it's plaid or pleat, whatever it's called, but the texture of it looks really, really cool, and I really wanted to retain that. And also, I love the fact that Mantle of Ephrodite has the gold tree. Usually, I hate that, but for this set, I like it because it just kind of gives it a little bit more personality. So, Hunters, let me know what you guys think. This is like one of my favorite sets that I've made in the game for a long time. And if you're like, I like this set, but Six Coyote is not that great. I love it. I use it a lot, but I do understand that. Don't worry, Girl Falcon looks amazing with this set as well. So you can just switch out Girl Falcon for this set and it'll still look super, super cool. Not as Viking themed, but it still looks good regardless. Next up is the Titans, and this one is really, really cool. Took a while for me to actually get this set just because of the shading situation with the chest piece, but we'll talk about that when we get there. For the helmet, Iron Companion was an easy choice just because, again, for this set specifically, I wanted a lot of fur. I'm being quite honest, if I'm doing a Viking set, I'm going to put as much fur as I can because for me, Vikings look way cooler with fur. I do understand that they didn't wear fur like historically. So I understand historically it's not accurate, but like media wise, they just look way better with fur. So Iron Companion helm, easy choice. Ursa Furiosa, this is funny. I tried Ursa Furiosa first, and I did actually come up with a really cool shader with it. But unfortunately, there's a few problems with it that I was just kind of like, I thought it was just a little too bright, which is kind of funny considering I'm using a white shader. But I didn't like the fact that it was like a brown bright, which I'm not a big fan of brown personally. So that's why I switched out. But for the chess piece, obviously Wolf Kiss Play, it was an easy choice. I am using the Ursa's Meridimus ornament because I switched out from brown. And if you guys don't know, Ursa Furiosa's fur, the base look of it is brown. You can't change color. That's why I switched out. I thought I should mention that. For the chest piece, Wolf Kiss Plate was an easy choice. Easy choice in the sense that it's such a cool helmet. It's very Viking themed and it has fur, but I did not think I was going to have this much trouble with it. And if I'm being quite honest, I still kind of don't like it that much, but I'll explain it when we get into the shading. For the boots, Meridian Constellation was an easy choice because it almost looked like runes, like Nordic runes on the boots. And it also does have a bit of fur in there as well, which is cool, but that wasn't the main focus. The focus was just the fact that the armor looks very like Nordic. And then for the Mark, Desolation Diver, honestly, this was kind of an easy choice as well, just because I wanted a big mark, but I didn't want anything too crazy. And I didn't want to go overboard with like fur. I think enough, like I have enough fur where it's like, this is fine. I don't need to add more, because I was thinking about adding the Iron Banner one that has fur. I forget what it's called. I was thinking about doing that with the barnacles, that one. I was thinking about adding that one, but I decided against it because I was like, I don't need more fur. Like, I'm fine as is. I just need something cool and that looks the piece. And I think Desolation Diver looks really good with this. So for the shader, we're using Amrita's Dream. Now, this is funny because I didn't need to use this technically. There's other shaders that I can combine it with, because if you guys don't know, Ursa Meridimus, the ornament, the bears on the pauldrons do not change color and they are a purple, specifically like Amrita's purple. So I just decided to lean into the purple. I didn't want to fight it. There's other shaders I could have used, but there's one shader that I'm thinking about. I think it's a Red Jack, Crucible Red Jack, I think it is, or Crucible Carmen. I don't remember which one it is off the top of my head. But those two shaders you can actually use together because they pair really well. But I didn't want red for this set just because this is a void set. Ursa Furiosa is a void exotic, and I just kind of wanted to stick with purple. The only thing that sucks is that the Wolf Kissed Plate chest piece, if you guys haven't seen my review for the Assassin's Creed set, I'll have it up right now because I do explain it further in that video. But to briefly explain, the fur on the Assassin's Creed set for the Titans is very difficult to shader. For Amrita's Dream specifically, the fur actually turns purple, and I didn't want that. I wanted everything to be cohesive and just white fur. So I literally went through all of the shaders, like all of the shaders that have purple, white, anything of the sort. And the only one that I found that was like decent was Dusk Mine. And unfortunately, this is a shader from Vanilla D2, so I don't even know if you can pick. Actually, you can pick this up. You're going to be able to pick this up with Ada's changes in the future, which I still haven't made a video on, but she will be selling shaders. So it's unfortunate because I don't think it's super, super perfect, because the fur on the chest piece is more gray than white. I know a lot of people are going to be like, I can't tell the difference, and that's fair, but I can, and it bugs me. But yeah, Titans, let me know what you guys think. I definitely think this is a banger. I think it's the only problem, just find a better shader for the chest piece, or just use other shaders that have purple that do a lot of a better job. But I don't think this looks bad by any means. I still think this looks super cool. I mean, I'm making a video on it and I do think it looks cool. But yeah, Titans, let me know what you guys think. And then last but not least, we are using the Stag for the Warlock. So this one is, I wanted to go for kind of like a shamanistic warlock, and I think I nailed it out of the park. I think it looks super cool. I think the fact that I'm using lichen robes might rub people the wrong way, but again, for a Viking, I just think fur looks amazing and you can't really go wrong with fur. So for the helmet, the Stag is an easy choice because I think like bones for a shamanistic Viking is kind of like a no-brainer for me. So the only thing that could make this look cooler would be like if there was like a helmet that had like a veil and bone pieces in the front. I think that would be cool. I also did explain that in the Assassin's Creed look, because it's still in my mind. I think that would look cool. For the arms, Meridian Constellation Wraps was an easy choice to pair with the Lightkin robes, just because it makes it look very like it's almost attached to the chest piece. It all looks cohesive, which is why I'm using it. For the boots, Holdfast Boots is a new addition to my arsenal, and I love it. I love these boots. I will say the Meridian Constellation boots might have been a better choice, just because the boots do have the like runic look to them. My only gripe about them is they're asymmetrical, and I didn't want that, so that's why I'm not using them. And then for the bond, we're using the Meridian Constellation bond, just because I really like the plate. It looks, it has the runes stuff in there as well, but I also like the glow as well. The only gripe is I maybe should have used a different glow for that, so that way it could be like either a red or a yellow, because if you guys don't know, the stag actually has fire in the eyes. You can't see it because it's really small fire, but there is fire in there. But for the shader, I ended up just going for an all black look. I know that's going to be boring for a lot of people, but for me, it was rough. It was actually really rough. Let's talk about the helmet. So the helmet, Metro Shift, is an easy choice. It does give silver on the cheeks, I think, but I don't really care about that. Most people are just going to look at the bone. For the arms, this is where it got difficult, because I really wanted to combine the Lightkin robes with the Meridian Constellation wraps, but I've never found a one-to-one shader for the Skelligal for Lightkin robes, because that's the one I usually go for. So I went through all of the shaders, damn near all of them actually, and Oiled Gunmetal, I think, looks perfect with it. I think it's all like, it's almost a one-to-one. It's not, because Oiled Gunmetal has a sheen to it that the chest piece does not, specifically the like elbow up does not have that sheen. But when you look at it like without it, it just like, it is a one-to-one. I love it. I absolutely love it. And this is the problems that I have when I make armor sets, is just I want to combine shaders for it to be like damn near one-to-one shader. The boots, Amethyst Veil is an easy choice because it just blacks everything, like all of it, which is really cool. And Amethyst Veil is really problematic with cloth, because it either gives you all black, white, which is really off, like weird off color, or you'll get the dark blue, which is like the regular off color. So really love the Amethyst Veil, just gave me the all black. And then for Dead Orbit's Fate for the Meridian Constellation, again, I think I should have chosen a better shader for this one, but I'm not regretful. I still think it looks cool. It's just, it is what it is. And then I wanted to show you guys how the helmet looks with the antlers, so that way you guys can see how it looks as a whole, because it does look really, really cool. So let me know what you guys think. Which one is your favorite? Personally, I think my favorite would have to be, it's rough. I think the Hunter for sure. But then the Warlock for sure is super cool. And if you want to know like my honest opinion, for the Meridian Constellation Bond, I think you should just switch that out for the Iron Banner Mark. Is it the Iron Banner? I think it's the Iron Banner Mark from the Barnacle set. I forget what it's called. But I think that bond looks way cooler with it. I just didn't want to use it because I use it a lot with the Lycan robes. Titans, I love your set as well. It's just the fact that the chest piece is so annoying to shader that I just cannot get over it. So if I find a better shadering situation for that one, I think that would probably be my favorite, just because everything is cohesive. But I think the Warlock also, I think all of these are just bangers. I'm gonna be real honest with you. I think all of these are really good. So let me know what you guys think. Be safe, and I'll see you guys later.